caution, to avoid overheating your storage system, you have 30 minutes to reinstall the repaired controller node once the controller node has been removed from its bay. Attach your ESD wrist strap to an unpainted surface of the enclosure or rack. Caution, to prevent data loss, confirm that the sass data cabling provides a redundant path to all of the enclosures from the healthy node. Confirm that the UID locate LED is solid blue on the node to be removed. This indicates that it is safe to remove. Confirm that all cables attached to the node are labeled, noting their locations. If not labeled, label them with node, slot, and port information. Remove the Ethernet cable from the management port by pressing the release tab and disconnecting the cable. Remove all fiber cables by pulling out the long tab underneath the SFP and disconnecting the SFP with the fiber cables attached. Remove sass cables by grasping the cable connector, pushing inward while pulling the long tab above the connector to release the cable from the port, and then disconnecting the sass cable. Fully loosen both captive thumb screws that secure the controller node handles to its enclosure bay. If too tight, use a Torx T15 screwdriver to loosen. Open both controller node handles simultaneously to disengage the node from the enclosure backplane and partially slide the node out of its bay. Caution, the node is long and heavy. Be prepared. While making sure that all cables are out of the way, support the node from underneath and carefully slide it out of its bay in the node enclosure. Place the removed node onto the flat anti-static surface nearby. Remove the top cover by pressing the black plastic release tabs on both sides of the top cover near the rear. Slide it back until it stops and lift the top cover up and off the node. Note, on the inside cover of the node, you will find a map that displays the locations of the boot drives, DIMMs, and node coin battery. Locate the node coin battery. Gently pull back the hook bracket that secures the coin battery just enough to access the battery. Caution, take care not to bend the hook bracket too far. Lift the coin battery up and out of its holder. With its positive side facing the hook bracket, insert the replacement coin battery into its holder with the hook bracket over the battery, securing it in place. Confirm that the coin battery is firmly in place. Replace the top cover by aligning the tabs in the front of the cover with the notches in the front of the chassis. Lower the cover and slide it forward to secure. Caution! Clear the area in front of the empty bay of any cables that might get snagged or damaged during reinstallation of the controller node. With its release levers in their open position, carefully align and slide the node into its bay until its release levers begin to engage. Close the release levers to fully seat the node into the enclosure backplane. Fully tighten both thumb screws to secure the node to the enclosure. Replace all the cables that were removed earlier, making sure that each cable is in the same location and fully connected.